Good morning and welcome to worship. I think you all know me, so I don't need to identify myself. On behalf of the congregation, I'd like to say a word of welcome to each of you this morning. I don't see any visitors with us, but we trust that all of you will experience a warm welcome from everyone else who is here today. We ask that you sign the red friendship register at the end of the pew. And if you're a visitor, even though you're not, if you're a visitor, go ahead and put your name there as well. So we know some individuals will be joining us later today by YouTube, and we welcome those folks as well. So welcome to everyone this morning. I'm sure by now you've noticed that our pastor, Don Macon, is not with us this morning. That's because Don is on vacation through next Sunday. In his absence today, we're going to share in a special time of remembrance of 9/11. Instead of a sermon, we'll join in a time of meditation, reflection, and individual silent prayer as Taylor plays some beautiful music for us. When we come to that part of the service, you are invited to sit back, relax, close your eyes if you wish, and reflect on what happened 21 years ago today. I want to express my personal appreciation to Taylor for sharing his musical talents with us this morning, so thank you. There are a number of announcements in the bulletin today. As Don said last week, if you park in the parking lot, you know that the roof over our heads is being replaced. There's a lot of material out there in the parking lot. Our operating budget funds cannot be used for roof replacement, and it would be wonderful if we did not have to use all of our reserve funds to cover the cost of that replacement. Therefore, you are invited to give a gift to help defray the cost of the new roof. Checks should be made payable to CPC and designated for roof replacement. So thank you so much for your assistance with that project. Our music programs are back up and running for youth and adults. The schedules are printed there in the bulletin. If you have any questions about anything, please speak with either Taylor or Angie. I want to remind you that today is the second Sunday of the month, meaning that we will receive the 2 cents a meal hunger offering as part of our regular offering today. We're also receiving funds to support relief efforts for those impacted by severe flooding throughout our nation. Checks should be made payable to CPC and designated either for flood relief or Presbyterian disaster assistance. Thank you for your help with that as well. Last but certainly not least, I would ask that you please keep all of the folks on the prayer list in your personal thoughts and prayers. I do have one addition to the prayer list. Gary Overstreet's father, Herbert Overstreet, is at Brandon Oaks Rehabilitation Center in Roanoke. He broke his hip, then he developed COVID, and now he has pneumonia. So please keep Gary's father, Herbert Overstreet, in your thoughts and prayers. Are there any other announcements or prayer concerns this morning? Okay, let's take a moment now to greet each other and extend to one another the peace of Christ.
Thank you.
and join me in a responsive call to worship printed in the bulletin. In the midst of a world where people hunger and thirst, we worship the God who feeds the hungry. In the midst of a world where people are abused and oppressed, we worship the God who calls for compassion and justice. In the midst of a world filled with wars and rumors of war, we worship the God who desires peace on earth. In the midst of a world of spiritual emptiness, we worship the God who gives life meaning. Come, let us worship God. Worship God, I'm sorry. A God whose grace and love never go in.
Too often we look at the world and see only violence,
destruction, pain, and signs of hopelessness and despair. Too often we rely on our own strength, our own plans, and our own devices, rather than trusting in your hand to hold us, your love to sustain us, and your wisdom to see us through. Forgive us, Holy One. Help us turn to you when we are lost, that we might find our way home. Help us navigate the treacherous waters of this world, that we might experience your abundant grace, mercy, and love. Help us put our trust in you, that the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus may shine in our lives for all to see. The mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting. I declare to you in the name of Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. May the God of mercy, who forgives all our sins, strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life. Amen.
Tears. What's the flashlight do?
It helps you see.
It helps you see. Can you see that better if I shine it on there?
Yeah.
What if I shine it on you? I can see you better. I won't shine it in your face. I can see you better. Yeah. Yeah. So a flashlight or a light helps us see stuff, doesn't it? Yeah. So I want to read you just a really, really short thing from the Bible, a short verse from the Bible, and it's about light. Have you ever heard anybody say that Jesus is the light of the world?
What?
Well, sometimes they say that. How about that? Listen to this for just a second. This is from Matthew, okay? This is Matthew 5, verse 14, and it's real short, so listen close. You are like light for the whole world. A city built on a hill cannot be hid. No one lights a lamp and puts it under a bowl. Instead, he puts it on the lampstand, where it gives light for everyone in the house. In the same way, your light must shine for people so that they will see the good things you do and praise your Father in heaven. So if I put this light under something, well, you might see the red through my hand, yeah. But you can't see it if I hide it, can you? What if we hid you? Would we see your wonderfulness if we hid you? So we want you to shine your light for the whole world, just like Jesus shines his light for all of us. Can you help me sing a song? I have a song about light. And we don't ever want to put our light under a bushel. We're going to let it shine. So I'm wondering, and since there's just two of us, I think you all might know this song called This Little Light of Mine. We were just going to sing it real quick, just to finish up our little children's moment this morning. Do you think you can sing it with me? Let's try.
This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine.
God breaks the bow and shatters the spear.
God warns the shields with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations. I am exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Let us now join in a time of meditation, individual prayer, and reflection while listening to some beautiful music that Taylor will provide for us.